So I'm getting asked a lot which Mac you should buy as your first Mac when you just started out with MWO and you ground some C-bills to actually have enough money to do so. And the question is really, really tough because it all comes down to personal preference and such. But I figured out six Macs for you today that I personally find very good and very forgiving for new players. And yeah, we are going to dive into those and have a little discussion about that. And by the way, the criteria I set for this are, first of all, mobility. You want to have a decent speed and mobility on the battlefield so that you can learn the maps very well and get yourself a good, sense of battlefield positioning. Second is armor and survivability, because you need to stay alive in the game pretty much, because if you are getting just shut down early on, you can't really learn the game. And the third thing is versatility. So different builds that you can do with the very first Mac so that you can figure out which playstyle suits best. And yeah, my six Macs that I got to you today are the Enforcer, the Huntsman, the Shadowhawk, the Hellbringer, the Thunderbolt and the Timberwolf. And we are starting out with the Enforcer here. So as you can see, those are only mediums and heavy Macs, but again, those are the ones that are catering towards the criteria the best. I'm taking the Enforcer 4R here because it is one that has a lot of energy weapon slots. And I think energy weapons are very good for beginners because you have a very long burn duration with them. You can adjust your aim when you're shooting at the enemy. And that one is really cool because it also has a lot of quirks for laser weapons. So as you can see, energy range, energy cooldown, heat and laser duration. And on top of that, a special one for the large laser range. So you can build something like that here. A large laser and medium laser, or you can make use of the ballistic hardpoint as well. So if you want, go ahead and build yourself an AC-10 and medium laser build, and you have a nice mixed build of firepower here. Also, the Mac runs about 84 kph with an XL engine of 260, so it is quite mobile and it has jump jets on top of that. So again, the Enforcer, very good at a mixed build between ballistic and laser weapons. The next Mac would be the Shadowhawk, which has an almost the same loadout, but it is highly favored for ballistic weapons. So taking the Shadowhawk 2H here, and as you can see on that, you have an amazing cooldown of plus 25% on the ballistic weapon. And again, you have 3 hard points for that. So if you want to go more to ballistic weapons, then take that. Also, the Shadowhawk has missile hard points, so you could probably add up some SRMs or even LRMs on that. And yeah, apart from that, it kind of plays like the same, like the Enforcer. So you have jump jets, you have a 55 ton mag, and you have a decent speed of about 80 kph with a standard engine 255. Again, just mix up the builds a bit. I have a lot of videos out on my channel that show different playstyles of that Shadowhawk here. But again, it is a very decent medium mag with a lot of mobility, a lot of different hard points. And you can do a lot of different builds with that early on without having too much of a single specialization here. If you want to go clan and you want to play medium mechs, I think the Huntsman is a very good mech just because you have options in that. So it is a 50 ton mech here. It is not as sturdy as the other ones because it has a little less armor. But again, it has a lot of jump jets. It has a decent speed of 80 kph. And I think you can sense a pattern here. So I think 80 kph is a very good number to maneuver yourselves around the battlefield and get to learn the maps. Also, the Huntsman is an Omnimag. That means that you can just switch out the components. If you just want to switch out that ballistic component here, in the left torso, you go ahead and get yourself another one, and suddenly you've got missiles and energy hardpoints here. So that is really cool in terms of versatility. So the clan mechs, of course, especially the Omni mechs, they have a lot of different options that you can choose, and you can do a ton of builds with that. So again, an Omni mech brings you a lot of versatility. You don't need to buy more mechs with that. You just change out or interchange those components here, those Omni pods. And that's really cool. But again, apart from that, you have very, very high mounts on that. You can just peek above hills. You just need to expose yourself onto that line and you're pretty fine. So you can play very, very safe early on. And again, learn the dynamics of the battlefield. So again, the Huntsman is a very nice pickup if you want to go for clan tech. So let's drop that here and go over to the heavy bracket. I chose the Hellbringer here for kind of the same reason. It is a 65-ton mech. It's a bit heavier. It is a bit more armored, and it has also, again, very, very nice high hard point. Also, the Hellbringer is able to carry ECM. You've got the Hellbringer Prime left torso, which is able to carry an ECM that makes you kind of invisible to the enemy sensors. So that one is very, very forgiving in terms of positioning, because you won't be a priority target. You will be shielded by your ECM. You can't be targeted by the enemy sensors. And that makes the Hellbringer a very nice pickup as your first mech. And again, 81 kph, you are very mobile here. And again, you have the amazing, amazing versatility by just switching out the Omnipods for some different stuff. Also, that was the same Omnipod. All right, let's go ahead and get another mech on the plan here, which is the Thunderbolt. It is the same weight bracket as the Hellbringer, but it is an Inner Sphere mech. And I chose this one again because of the amazing energy quirks. As you can see, energy heat generation, which is very important as a new player, because heat management is a big thing in the game, and you kind of need those little quirks to actually keep you going. And apart from that, it kind of plays like the same as before. You've got a lot of energy hard points here in the left torso, and you got two missile hard points in the right torso that enables you to take some SRM as backup or even LRM. And the Thunderbolt 5S that I'm showing you here also has two ballistic hardpoints in the left arm. You could, if you want, you could go for even a ballistic loadout if you just want to try it. But to be honest, the Thunderbolt is not good carrying them because it doesn't have any quirks. And yeah, the slots are limited. You could go for an AC-10 or maybe an LB-10 here in the left arm. But again, the Thunderbolt excels at energy boating here, and this is what you should do with that. And on top of that, the Thunderbolt 5S is a very good standard engine carrier. So that one is very, very tanky. You could just lose one of your side tosses and you're still dangerous, because you have either still the SRMs or LRMs left, and on the other side, the large lasers. So it is very sturdy in general. So a Thunderbolt is a very nice pickup as a 65-tonner, and having that standard engine 270 here again brings the mech to 72 kph, which is not around 80, but it is still enough. The last mech that I want to show you here is the good old Timberwolf. It is the icon of the Battletech universe, or one of the icons here. And it is an Omni-mech. It runs about 80-ish kph. So this one has speed tweak unlocked, and therefore it runs a bit faster. It has 87 kph. And you have, again, a lot of different Omnipods that you can choose from, enabling you a lot of different builds. So you've got ballistic hardpoints, you got missile hardpoints. You also got some Omnipods with jump jets, but don't rely too much on jump jets. They are just for getting a bit more mobility in that stuff here, in that mech here, getting over obstacles and such. It is not good at just jumping up and, yeah, jumping up into very high positions and shoot from above. But apart from that, it is a 75-ton mech, very, very heavy, has a lot of armor to work with, has a very nice hard points, and you have got some good energy weapons in the arms, so you've got options here. And again, the Timberwolf is a very nice pickup as well, because it is tanky, it is really, really sturdy, and mobile on top of that. And yeah, if I have to choose my favorite of all of those, it would probably be the Shadowhawk, because I like the Shadowhawk in general. But I think the Hellbringer or the Timberwolf are very decent first pickups here. Again, you have options with other mechs as well, but try to get yourself a mech that runs around 80 kph, that has somewhat of a good armor number and a versatility, so that you can actually, you know, learn the game, find yourself your sweet spot, find yourself your preferred play style, and yeah, learn the game and get better at that. And I think that is my favorite six here. Let me know what you guys think. I think there are a lot of seasoned players out there that have other opinions, maybe. If you have any good suggestions for newer players, let me know down below in the comments. And if you liked the video, don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel. And I hope to see you on the battlefield, everybody. Goodbye.